Hey everyone, welcome back to Davenridge European Martial Arts Backyard. Although today I'm in the school because I needed to pick some things up here. I hope everyone is staying safe, being smart about what we're doing, and I'm really excited about seeing you when this is all gone. Today, I want to talk to you just a little bit about how to use an axe to swing it around with one solo drill, but more importantly, how to protect your fingers as you're using it. Not just with the two-handed axe, but also with a one-handed hatchet, tomahawk, boarding axe, anything like that. Let's go ahead and get started on it. I just wanted to give you a little fun that you can have if you've got a two-handed stick, whether it's an axe or it's a broom or just a tree branch. You can do this with a sword, however, it's not going to work as well because we're looking at using the haft and the head to protect the hands. As we're in here, we're going to start with a wide grip. Our solo drill is going to be starting here, cutting down with a slide, pulling back, sliding out again to capture to that side, opening the hand, sliding to drive it here with a thrust. Once again, over the top to cut, bring it around like I'm using a false edge of a sword. Open up my hand as I slide it to the head to cover my head, bring it around, cut down, and then cut one more time. From this side, a little something sliding in and out and opening your fingers to protect your hand will give you the ability to use the haft of your axe and not lose fingers in the process. This same concept goes over to the tomahawk or hatchet, which I'll do next. Here's a little drill that you can do with a tomahawk, or this one's a boarding axe, medieval, whatever you want to work with. The idea is that with this weapon, there are three different grips. We have a grip, we'll call this a full haft. This is going to give me the greatest striking blows and the longest distance. However, if I'm a little bit closer, we may want to drop down to a half haft. This one is going to allow me to get little quick snaps in, and I can always use the other haft of the axe haft as a grappling tool. This is not a good way to stop an incoming attack because it will cost you fingers. For that, we go to our third grip. Our third grip is going to be choked, and that's all the way up top. For this one, I use it for punching actions and for ripping actions. When I'm using this haft choked, I can use the back end for hooking and grappling, I can use the head for punching, and I can use the beak for thrusting, and I can use the bottom for ripping. This gives me up close ability while controlling my axe and using it like I've got edged brass knuckles on. The final way that we can use the choked grip is if
We come in, you lift up your thumb, and then you rotate your fingers around. And that puts my fingers over the top of my axe. That means that now I've got this protecting my arm against incoming attacks, and I can transfer to the choked position quickly. This is not something that comes quickly or easily. It is something that you need to practice in order to get that into position. If you're going to go from a choked grip to a full haft grip, don't just let it slide in your hand, because if you're hot, sweaty, whatever, you have zombie goo all over your handle and your hand, doing this means you can lose control of it. This is also going to be the way that you would pull it out of your belt. Once you pull it out, holding it in the choke position, drive it into your hip to the full haft. So I hook, I pull, I drive to full haft, and I'm ready to go into my fight. This position on the choke grip is like what we did with the other apps where I open my fingers. But because I only have one hand on this weapon, I need to maintain control with my fingers over the top. And I can just drive right back into my grip as I need it. So there's a quick little video about a couple different ways that you can move your hand around on the haft of your axe. Whether it's a one-handed axe, or you have the two-handed axe. In either case, remember, there's no guard. And if you get your fingers broken, you are not going to be using that weapon anymore. So protect your hands using the head of the axe. When I'm talking about going to the position of from the choked grip to protect your hand, I want you to see the damage to the handle of this axe. All of those strikes are from people trying to hit me with a sword. And it's quite chewed up. If I was holding it here, you can see how many of those positions are covered by my fingers. That would have cost me my fingers. This position here puts all of those, you can see, just inside my forearm. That's how I can close distance to come in, drop down, and be able to punch, or rake, or hook for disarm or grapples. So there you go, a little bit of use of the axe and how to protect your fingers. I hope you're all staying safe, stay smart, and we'll see you on the other side